Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo. In this video, we're going to go over manipulating brightness and contrast for uncovering text within a photo. On a few occasions during an OSINT investigation, I've come across photos shared by a target in which, by using some very basic photo manipulation techniques, I'm able to extract additional information. By simply altering the photo's brightness and contrast, I've been able to use this technique in many cases, such as reading license plates on a car when the photo was taken at night, or for extracting text from a face-down piece of paper, which is what we're going to cover here. So we have two versions of the same photo on the screen here. On the left side of my screen, I have a sample image showing a face down piece of paper that I want to extract the text from. And on the right of my screen, I have a copy of that same photo opened up in the Gimp photo editing software. Keep in mind, you're going to want to make sure you always work with a copy so you don't accidentally save over your original. Now, without doing any image manipulation, we can clearly see that there is some text printed on the opposite side of this page. And if we zoom in, there's probably even some characters that we can make out, keeping in mind that this page is face down and so the text is going to be backwards. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to flip the page over. We're going to do that by going to Image, Transform, and Flip Horizontally. Now, if we zoom back in, once again, we can clearly see some of the text here. You know, this does appear to say application for visa, this appears to say middle name, and this does appear to say first name right here. But some of this text is a little bit more ambiguous, and we can't quite read it the way it is right now. So we're going to zoom back out, center the photo, and what we're going to want to do is we're going to increase the brightness and contrast of this image so that we can better read the text that's on this page. So simply go up to colors, go down to brightness and contrast, and as we start increasing the contrast on this page, you're going to notice that the whole page does become a little bit brighter, but you're also going to get to a point where you're going to start seeing some washout right here, and that's a little bit too much. We don't want to lose the text that we're trying to obtain. So when you get to this point, you're just going to drop down the brightness to counteract that washout. Then we're going to increase a little bit more of the contrast, bring down the brightness. And this is about to the point where we want to get to right here. This looks pretty good. So we're going to click OK. And then if we zoom back in, we can clearly see that this does indeed say application for visa up at the top. This is indeed first name, middle name, family name. And if we scroll over, we can see nationality here. We can now make out. We can see email, current address, telephone. And here's what's important. So date of previous visit to Thailand. So we do know that this is an application for a visa. This does appear to say royal something, consulate. But going down here and seeing, the date of previous visit to Thailand, it's a pretty safe assumption that this is indeed a application for a visa to go to Thailand. So another thing to keep in mind is if our target had actually entered text, typed it in on any of these fields here, we'd be able to make that out just as clearly as we can the rest of this form. And so that's pretty much it. We have the before and after here. Keep in mind, this technique's not going to be something that works for every photo. The success is heavily dependent on the original photo's lighting, contrast, and how high the quality of the original photo actually is. But as you can see, just this little bit of simple photo manipulation can actually go a very long way.